I'm sure you know there are risks in investment, and you also understand the risk-reward relationship. Have you heard of liquidity risk in investment? In which investments it applies and what are its implications? Let us get familiar with this liquidity risk in order to manage it better. My name is Jiten Modi, son of a driver, born and brought up in typical Indian village, a brilliant student at academics, a cricket fanatic, once a corporate zombie and a pathetic money manager, turned into a financial strategist on a mission to help 1 million families make their money work harder through informed financial decision making. Liquidity risk simply implies that it is difficult to sell an investment when needed, or it has to be sold below its fair value, or there are high costs to carrying out transactions. In simple words, it is the situation where one faces problem when we need cash from our investment. Some investments like real estate, investments in art and antiques are illiquid as they are characterized by low volumes and high values. In other words, any investments involving huge amount of money and low volumes carry liquidity risks. Apart from real estate, art and antiques, retail investors face liquidity risk in corporate debt and precious metal market like gold, as very few ready buyers are available, and those available ready buyers might quote lower price. Some financial instruments like PF, PPF, ELSS, mutual funds have minimum holding period, popularly known as lock-in period. Getting your money back during this minimum holding period or lock-in period is also a liquidity risk. Some instruments like bank FD involves penalty for liquidating your investment prematurely. Equity markets are deep and illiquid. However, there are few companies whose shares are not traded frequently and are subject to liquidity risk. I am sure you are now aware what liquidity risk is and hence in a position to manage it in a better way. Stay tuned for more financial updates and stay blessed.